And we have pulled the room, and you will be go for the deorbit burn. I hate to bring you back down so early after extending 2 days. I know you're trying to beat Jerry Ross's time on orbit, but it's looking pretty good for this rev.
We copy all of that. Go for the deorbit burn. I don't know if we have much cryos to stay up 2 hours longer.
Okay, I'm Captain Charlie Hobart. They are giving the official word to the crew of Discovery that they are go for the deorbit burn. That burn coming up in 24 minutes and 33 seconds. Once again, Discovery's two orbital maneuvering system engines will fire for one final time. 2 minutes, 31 seconds. It will slow Discovery down by 188 miles per hour. And that will send Discovery back into the atmosphere, heading down toward the Kennedy Space Center. We will be landing on runway 15 today. That is the northwest to southeast approach there at KSC. The weather looking very, very favorable today. There's some light winds, sunny day, just a few clouds in the sky. Just 30 seconds to Space Shuttle Discovery's deorbit burn. Once again, this will be 2 minutes and 27 seconds long. Both orbital maneuvering systems will fire 6,000 pounds of thrust each. That will be enough to slow down Discovery by 188 miles per hour. And at that point, Discovery will be on its way toward the Kennedy Space Center with a landing on runway 15. The team reports that the burn has been enabled, standing by. Mission Control confirms that both orbital maneuvering system engines are now firing. Discovery is still heading down toward the southeast. It'll be approaching the western edge of Australia here shortly. Once this burn is completed, it will take 1 hour for Discovery to reach that part of the world to the Kennedy Space Center in Florida. It'll go from Mach 25 down to zero in that amount of time.